Yeah. Caramba.
I gotta tell you, I am a notorious pack rat and a junk hound. And luckily, I have a brother who works with me. Whenever I find things and go on these little shopping sprees, he's willing to go and pick it up for me and bring it back here. And this is a load of stuff I just found, and I wanna show you some of the pieces. For instance, take a look at this little nightstand. It's really not that old, but look, it's perfect for a bedside table. I'm gonna paint it a different color. And take a look at this table. This is kind of a prize, I think, because you could fold up the back like this and lean it against the wall and place things on it here. And then if you wanted to play a game on it, all you have to do is do this. That's why they're called game tables. It's really fantastic. So I'm really proud to find that.
The way I understand it, this is a plantation desk, and they would document, you know, whatever they, you know, sold, and they'd put it on a ledger, and, you know, whatever, and then they'd keep the paperwork in here.
It came out of the Mississippi River Delta. The English call this a tallying desk.
And then, of course, they would put some of their more pricey stuff or whatever, documents they want people to see, they put them in there, and then they'd have a key and lock it. They couldn't get into this.
And this little side table here is kind of interesting. My sense is that the base of it is old, but someone has reworked the top. And what they've done is they've made a pine top. Looks like it's made with at least three pieces of wood on top and two on either side. And they very cleverly placed a checkerboard on the top, which is kind of fun. I may leave it like that, but I do believe these legs are really quite old. The profile reflects probably an 1830s, 1840s style. This would be a candidate for painting. I don't have a problem painting furniture that's been mucked with or is in bad shape.
This is what I've gone crazy over. This piece. This is about 1720s with this wonderful paint. Oh, it's just fabulous. Look, I just love this paint.
Just look how they've dribbled paint of all different colors and shapes. And I just thought it was just too cool for the money. And I'll figure out a fun place to put that. But these two things are working really well, be great in a bathroom. And take a look at this cast iron horse I found. It's really heavy. And I'm thinking about mounting it on a stem and putting it on a base. And she's at a full gallop, so I want to go show my horse Trudy this so she'll get the idea she needs to be getting a little more exercise.
I like this little table over here's got sexy legs, man.
Yeah, this is cool, sexy. Yeah, this is painted too.
We got these for $27.
They're steel. I love those. Those are simple like us.
They have excellent, excellent seats in them. Probably made in the 1920s or 30s. They show a nice patina, but I bought all six of these chairs for $150. And they're really solid. They're not gonna require any gluing. I could paint them, I could leave them natural. They're made of oak, and they've got that wonderful sort of jute seat in them. Really, really in good condition.
No, it's 40 and a half inches. That's a big old tree. It's 1 foot thick. Wow, that's 1 foot there. It's 30 inches on ground. I like that, but man, it just takes up a lot of room.
I am thrilled to find this butcher block. It's 42 inches in diameter. I've been looking for butcher blocks for probably 2 years now, and I found them everywhere from $1,200, $1,500. And the cheapest one I found is about $800. Paid $400 for this one. And then I found this pot rack, which I think the proportions are really good. And the pot rack was $93. And I found it in a completely different place than when I was looking around in this area and found it. And I just think it's a great fit. Now the butcher block is really kind of low. And what I'm thinking is that, you know, we're probably not gonna use it for chopping up meat. But what I want to do is figure out a way to raise it up a little higher. It'll make a perfect island in the kitchen. So, and I love the patina on the side, the way in which the white is sort of weathered. And that brings me to the last find. For $50, I found this old chandelier. It's not wired. It'll be perfect for hanging in a garden house with some candles for a lovely candlelight meal. So if you're enjoying following some of these style ideas and finds for treasures, make sure you tell a friend about it. Check in regularly because I'm always out on the hunt. And subscribe to eHowHome.